next few moments is, I just want to share something from my heart, okay? This comes from my heart. This is not from a position of anger. This isn't from a position of anything. This comes from my heart, that I think that I have to be true to my role as your pastor, okay? As I know over the next couple of weeks, with election just around the corner, we already, the culture and everything is, there's just this spirit, right? And so I think that more than ever is that we have to make sure that we are honoring to God in this. And here's what I want to say honoring to God. First and foremost is when we look biblically through the authority of scriptures, that we understand that first of all, under the authority of God, he has placed government over top of us. In the government that which we have the opportunity and the right to vote and the opportunity to do so. So I believe that it's our calling as followers of God to be involved in the elections, is that we vote. In fact, the last election, last presidential election was decided less than 42,000 votes. There was an estimated 30 million Americans who call themselves Christians that did not vote, were not involved in the election. Can you imagine a voice that would be heard if we came together and said, listen, this is what we believe, and this is what we stand for? And I think more than ever, I've pulled back from politics, but what I believe is now politics is pushing into the church. I think that politics is trying to push us, and so this is trying to convince us that we ought to, some deeply held convictions that we've had and beliefs that we have as the church, politics are beginning to push in on us, so it's time we push back on them. All right? Can I say it that way? It's time that we start standing up and say, this is what we believe, this is who we are. And so when it comes into voting, here's a couple things that we have to frame our thinking in. I want to give you these things. Here you are. Number one, as we vote based upon character, not outward appearance of a candidate. We vote based upon character. Scripture tells us God, as he came and he called David, he says that God does not look at the outward appearance, but he looks in the inner appearance. He looks at the character of who they are. As we don't vote on outward appearance. Very quick illustration of that. Some years ago, LBJ versus Kennedy in the election. LBJ, it was a landslide. He was going to win the election. But it was the first time that any type of a debate was on television. And everyone got a first glimpse of JFK, and he was a young, attractive man. LBJ was old and kind of sweaty and looked disheveled. And literally the next day, he lost the election. And what it proved to us across the American landscape is we vote based upon appearance. So we do not pick a candidate, whether they're the same race, whether they are a male or a female, they come from, whether they're white, black, green, or orange. They're orange. Say, I'm orange, so I'm going to vote for them. Some of you guys get that. As we do not vote on the outside appearance, we vote based upon character and character alone. Secondly, is we then vote on Christian principle. Not financial flourishing. Is in the last 15 elections, when asked people why they voted, people will talk about all sorts of things about deep conviction, but the truth is what's best financially, best for them is how people vote. So what we as followers of Jesus is that we should not be driven what is financially easy, but rather what is the deep held Christian principles. It's the things that we value most, drives us to how we should vote and how we should respond. Is that we begin to say, God, what is, where are you leading me to represent and also to honor? Next is then also personal convictions. As we pray and we come before God and say, God, what are the convictions that you are breaking my heart on? And we vote based upon personal conviction, not anger or not popularity, but rather what God is driving us towards. But this is the most important part, is regardless of who wins or loses the election, as a follower of Jesus, we always remain humble. We always remain humble, and we bow our knee before God. Because at the end of the day, as we are not big D Democrats, big R Republicans, we are big C Christians. We are followers of Jesus and Jesus alone. And there is going to be no president who is going to save us from our deepest issue, and the deepest issue is sin. And it's only a Savior that can rescue us from sin. And at the end of the day, it's only through Jesus who is going to heal and save our nation. But as a followers of God, it's also a time where we say, listen, this is what we believe and this is what we hold to be true, what God is calling us to be. So may we, in the next couple of weeks, be God's people and honor him in all things. Okay? Thank you. We're never gone.
want to change the world by standing.